So every fall, many, many juniors in high school throughout the country take the PSAT. And many of these students are competing for the National Merit Scholarship Program. So the way it works is they'll take about the 50,000 highest scores. Out of all the students who take it throughout the country, they'll take the 50,000 highest scoring individuals, and they become National Merit Scholar Letter of Commendation winners. And that is announced in April of junior year. And then in September of senior year, of 12th grade, they'll announce the semifinalists. So out of those 50,000 winners, there will be about 16,000 semifinalists. The semifinalists will submit their SAT scores. Now that they've taken the SAT, they'll submit an essay, and they'll also submit grades and courses they've taken. And about 16,000 out of the 15, out of about 15,000 out of the 16,000 will actually become finalists. And most of those finalists are going to receive funding of some kind. They're either going to get scholarships from corporations, they're going to get scholarships from the colleges that they attend. Many colleges will give, sometimes just a few thousand dollars. Sometimes they'll give a half or even a full scholarship based upon being a merit finalist. So it's a pretty big deal. And then 8,000 of those, about 8,000 of those finalists are going to actually receive money from the National Merit Scholarship Program. But all 15,000 finalists are probably going to receive funding in some way, either, like I say, from corporations, from the colleges they attend, or from the National Merit Scholarship Program.